All right, cheap, expensive. We're gonna be doing a test today. I always kind of thought something like this might be fun. We have the cups that come with your TIG when you buy it. We have the cheapest Amazon gas lenses I could find. And we have actual Furic cups. Honestly, you can probably tell which one I'm using the most, but I'm gonna try to keep it unbiased. We have 4130 chromoly, 316 stainless, and completely uncleaned, unwashed, and still has the mill scale, mild steel. I think this is really gonna show. A lot of people buy their first TIG and they don't even know you have to clean the metal. I wanna show how this stuff can handle it. We also have a ringer, but we'll get to this more later. So let's start welding. having to kind of unscrew the center here to try to get it out of my torch, because this is just freely spinning. Well, that's going to skew my results. I'm glad I got all the welding out of the way for this one. But I think what happened is it got hot enough where it basically popped the threads, because there is threads here, but it very clearly kind of came out while I was trying to take the tungsten out, which is real weird. Yeah, kind of screwed up my filter there a little. Let's keep going. We're gonna make this guy a little bit shorter here. Still long as hell. I'm pulling my hand a lot further away from where I'm usually keeping it for welding. Interesting. First half, not too bad. Second half was way too hot. Now, why that's interesting, I could have backed off the pedal more, but I'm actually finding that this cup, like, there's so much gas flow in some of this stuff that it's actually kind of helping keep things cool as you're welding. Where you have to be very careful, especially if you're used to welding with something like this. I haven't used one of these since probably welding school. I'm gonna turn this around and I'm going to weld a little bit more on the other side now that I kind of, you know that that's a problem, but really, really interesting. Still running hotter than you would expect. It definitely welded. Can't say that it's pretty, but it welded. Thank you. So, you're thinking to yourself, hey, I'm smart. Why am I going to give somebody else like $60, $70 for a TIG cup, right? When I have a piece of copper pipe, a piece of Scotch-Brite, some JB Weld, and an old broken TIG cup. Pretty drastic difference so far. Should you throw out all your really nice fancy Furic cups and just buy a huge stock of Scotch-Brite and make your own cups? Probably not. I was welding with that for about 10 minutes and it was already starting to get a little bit crispy, especially going around the tubes. You do kind of have to get a little closer. T-joints, stuff like that, you can kind of get a little further away. I knew that would work before I even tried it today. Because I used to do it when I bought my first machine and I was just doing odd jobs for people. And every once in a while, someone would bring me, you know, a broken bracket on something stainless. And you have to make do. I didn't have the money for the nicer stuff. So, you know, that being said, this is a test that I've wanted to do for a long time. And I was kind of surprised. The stock cup, which I have not used one of those since I first started welding about 10 years ago, it did better than I thought, especially on the completely uncleaned mild steel. I didn't get porosity this time, and the weld was okay. You know, it was dull, it's what you would expect. That being said, these were random pieces that I pulled out of the scrap bin. I purposefully didn't clean them because I thought if there was going to be a massive difference between the cups, that's where it would show up. And it still did. That being said, if there was any paint on that, any grease, you know, anything other than just the mill scale, I think we would have seen a lot of porosity on the stock cup versus the Furic cup and stuff like that. They just dissipate more smoke, which means you can kind of get away with more. And that should really be the moral of the story here, is that if you're a competent welder who's, you know, worked on enough stuff, you really should be able to, without much test in between, weld with any of these cups. You know, perfect scenarios, any of these cups, you could weld things together and you know, it's not going to kill somebody. But the Furic stuff is just letting you get away with more. Let's say you have to stick that tungsten out way further than what is recommended. Odds are it's probably going to work. Where a stock cup, you know, I ran a number 8 today. You don't have that gas diffusion. You're barely sticking that tungsten out just a little bit. The Amazon cup was kind of a mixed bag. It was threaded together in the middle, and it seemed to hold up okay until it got hot. And then after that, every time I would weld with it, you know, if you had to move the tungsten at all, it was clear that it was skipping threads, and it was just kind of a pain in the ass. It did work. And actually, on the Chromoly, it worked better than I thought it was going to. That being said, it was only $12. So if you got your first TIG machine, you know, Amazon special, and you just want to weld something every once in a while, the Amazon cup, if you left it alone, maybe it would be okay. We're obviously not welding with the bigger Furic cups today, nor are we welding anything crazy exotic. You know, we don't have titanium and stuff like that here. That's where you're really going to see an even bigger difference. But, you know, the homemade cup, it was a piece of copper pipe and JB Weld. We're talking cents, you know, like it was completely homemade. So, what's my winner? Yeah, I mean, the Furic stuff is staying. It's just better. I've used it for years. I don't know anybody who welds seriously on a regular basis who's not using the Furic stuff. It's just better. It's just better. That being said, if you bought your first budget machine and you're going to weld once every 6 months, can you rationalize that much better? That's up to you. So, thanks for watching today. And I'm really curious what people are going to think of this. I kind of kept stuff that I knew I had and made the tests that I could come up with. What would you have tested? What do you want to see? Is there any other joints that you think would show an obvious difference? Let me know down in the comments. And I know this is a little bit of an odd video, but thanks for watching. If you hate me, tell me down below. If you want to subscribe, button somewhere. So, peace.